Let's begin with a case. This is a 15-year-old Taekwondo athlete with a chronic anterior cruciate ligament rupture and a posterior root tear of the medial meniscus. Now, do you see the lesion indicated by the pink arrow? That is a posterior root tear of the lateral meniscus. This patient underwent anterior cruciate ligament reconstruction along with repair of both the medial and lateral meniscus posterior roots. Today, we're examining the posterior root of the lateral meniscus. It provides secondary stability in ACL-deficient knees. This structure is challenging to visualize on both MRI and arthroscopy due to its variable attachment sites and unique configuration, making it a frequent diagnostic challenge. Let's take a look at a normal sagittal image of the knee. Try to locate the posterior root of the lateral meniscus here. Understanding the normal anatomy is the foundation for recognizing pathology. Knowing the insertion sites is crucial. The first attachment is on the posterior slope of the lateral tibial tubercle, which corresponds to the minor component of the LM posterior root. The second is at the medial tibial tubercle, along the intertubercular crest, just posteromedial to the anterior cruciate ligament tibial insertion and anterior to the posterior cruciate ligament. This is the major component. It extends all the way to the posterior aspect of the ACL tibial attachment. If we think about it generally, since we wouldn't expect the lateral meniscus posterior root to be located this far, we sometimes misidentify this root as different meniscal tissue. In about 76% of cases, the posterior root of the lateral meniscus has two attachments. About 24% of cases show only one of these attachment sites. On axial images, the posterior root of the lateral meniscus appears as a thin, oblique, low-signal band. But sagittal and coronal images tend to be more helpful. First, let's look at the minor component of the posterior root of the lateral meniscus that attaches to the posterior slope of the lateral tubercle. This is best seen on coronal images, and like the posterior root of the medial meniscus, it's a short ligament. It appears briefly on just one cut in the coronal image. Next, let's examine the more major component of the root located in the intertubercular area. On sagittal images, this structure often appears as a thin, low-signal band running parallel to the tibial plateau. It courses anteromedially from the posterior horn of the lateral meniscus, running along the intertubercular crest. Compared to other meniscal roots, it appears longer and less striated. On coronal views, look for small, dark foci crossing the intertubercular crest. These fibers anchor near the medial tibial tubercle. Think of them as tiny dots or short bands traversing bone. Now, let's talk about common diagnostic pitfalls. The posterior root of the lateral meniscus can be mistaken for the oblique meniscomeniscal ligament, the meniscofemoral ligaments, or displaced meniscal fragments in bucket handle tears. We will explore each of these mimickers in more detail later. For now, remember this: always trace the structure back to its meniscal origin and bony insertion. And keep in mind that even if you see only one component, it does not necessarily indicate a tear. About 24% of individuals have a solitary attachment. Thank you. Join the 2025 MSK MRI Seminar by musculoskeletal radiologist Ji-Eun Lee, author of Visualizing MSK Radiology. To register, contact Kunja Publishing.